In general terms, slurries are mixtures of solid particles in a carried fluid. On the one hand, the carried fluid may be water or some other Newtonian liquid. On the other, it may be a non-Newtonian liquid or a mixture of water and small particles which may behave like a non-Newtonian fluid. There are many different slurries that are conveyed in the various industries. Settling slurry flows are flows of coarse particle slurries with Newtonian carrier. They are of great importance in mining, dredging, and other industries like power plant waste treatment and oil sands production. In order to evaluate and quantify the production, efficiency, and safety of a slurry transport system composed of a pump and a pipeline, it is necessary to define suitable parameters describing properties of slurry and those of the slurry flow. Let's talk about the production. In the slurry transport, the solids are normally the payload, while the conveying liquid is only the vehicle. Hence, the volumetric flow rate of solids, QP, is an important parameter, and it is related to the total volumetric flow rate of mixture QM. Through the delivered solids concentration, CVD, which is defined as the ratio of the two flow rates. The average velocity of slurry flow, VM, is obtained if QM is divided by the flow cross-sectional area A. Let's move on with the efficiency. The specific energy consumption, SEC, is a measure of the energy required to move a given quantity of product over a given distance. It is directly proportional to a simple dimensionless ratio of the friction hydraulic gradient, IM, and the delivered solids concentration, CVD, for various solids of certain relative density, SP. That is the ratio between the density of the particles, rho P, and the density of water, rho W. If the power supply to the pump is required to ensure the transport, the expression must be divided by the pump efficiency, and the efficiency of the drive can be taken into account in the same way. In a horizontal straight pipe of constant diameter, the drop of static pressure in the slurry flow along the length of the pipe is due exclusively to friction. The hydraulic gradient IM is the ratio between the pressure drop delta P and the product of the three terms, namely the density of water, the gravitational acceleration G, and the length of the pipe L. This hydraulic gradient varies with the flow velocity VM, and a curve showing the relation between the hydraulic gradient and the flow velocity is called the pipe characteristic curve. The lower the specific energy consumption, the more energy effective the pipeline transport is. Not surprisingly, it is found that the basic requirements for minimum energy consumption are a large value of the delivered concentration and a value of the velocity at the minimum in the pipe characteristic curve for this concentration. Finally, let's talk a bit about the transport safety. A pipe characteristic curve, together with the pump characteristic curve, determines the flow rate and the velocity at which the conveying will take place in a pump pipeline transport system. It is important that the velocity ensures safe transport, free of danger of pipeline blockage. In practice, it means that the flow velocity exceeds the deposition limit velocity, VDL, which is the flow velocity at which stationary deposit starts to be formed in a slurry flow because the first particles stop moving and accumulate at the bottom of the pipe. This velocity occurs in all types of settling slurry flows, although its value differs significantly with the pipe size D, the particle size dp, in addition to the relative density sp, and the delivered concentration CVD.